today. Let's get these gates open.
Azgarath, Alec, and Jamie entering the arena on the right side of your screen for ABC. Gorecki, Chun-Li, and Thugonomics off the bench entering on the left side. The boys here. North America versus Europe to start the day off with game number one.
Ooh, Thugonomics making his debut in this tournament on the Destruction Warlock. Very well-versed in the specialization. Chun-Li now taking a little bit of pressure. Looks like Chun-Li is going to be sitting on Alec, trying to reduce some of his damage. And we've seen Chun-Li do a good job with his Disable Root, with his Ring of Peace, with his stuns, keep targets in line of sight of Thugonomics so we can get off that Chaos Bolt damage, that Destro Warlock burst. And I think if the boys can consistently do that, they will be able to find a kill in this match.
All right, let's see what Thugonomics can get done here. ABC were anticipating a Windwalker Death Knight, and the boys anticipated that anticipation and then substituted in Thugonomics on Destruction Warlock. So the boys not 100% countering their competition, but at least they didn't walk into the trap that would have been a melee cleave matchup into this Wizard Cleave setup, which we've seen so favored towards the Wizards and the Spellcasters in general. So I do like that the boys are utilizing that four-player roster, bringing in their fourth to try and get some diversity. We see Chun-Li currently activating powerful cooldowns as we see both of those abilities glowing below his health bar. Looks like Alec's going to be the target. Touch of Death explodes. Big hit. Azgarath had Ironbark rolling to reduce the damage, actually re-stealthing out of a Cyclone and stunning Chun-Li. Nice awareness by Azgarath, slowing down the pressure and allowing Alec to easily survive.
Yep, so ABC's main objective in this game is to limit what Thugonomics can do. They want to limit his spellcasting, so Jamie with his Earth Shear, or with his Wind Shear, his Grounding Totem, Alec with all of his snares and his Counterspell, they want to be interrupting Thugonomics, just keeping him in place and trying to line of sight as much damage as possible. As it is unlikely Thugonomics goes down early on, but later on in the game, he becomes a big vulnerability for the boys. So the ABC really want to drag this game on as long as possible.
Good crowd control chain on Gorecki as he sits through a full Hex and into a Polymorph. Thugonomics stunned up. Big burst coming through here for ABC. Unending Resolve needs to be enough for Thugonomics, and it looks like it's going to be. Thugonomics calling in that Infernal. It's going to be big damage for him if he is able to get some Chaos Bolts off here. ABC need to avoid it. They don't even seem to care. They're just pushing him over. Thugonomics going to fall this early on. Gorecki stunned up. Thugonomics getting lower and lower. Alec secures further crowd control. Chun-Li supporting with some Expel Harm heals, but even that not going to be strong enough. Gorecki, Gladiator's Medallion Ironbark. Big cooldowns from Gorecki to survive this assault, and ABC continue pushing.
Yeah, ABC's been doing a really good job. Alec, with his kiting, with his polymorphs, with his positioning, has really been limiting the offense of the boys in this matchup. I'm not sure if the boys were totally prepared for that. Chun-Li tried to get some pressure rolling onto Jamie, but now back on Alec. Thugonomics still the target of choice for ABC as he's caught into the midfield. Can they get crowd control on Gorecki is the question. He's got no Gladiator's Medallion, no Ironbark, which leaves the boys semi-vulnerable.
All right, let's see if they can make it to that point. 10 more seconds on that vital Ironbark of Gorecki. 8 more seconds. If ABC can engage crowd control prior to this moment, Thugonomics will be in danger. Thugonomics is doing a good job fearing Jamie. Chun-Li has Alec under control. Chaos Bolt interrupted. Good denial. Very important when facing a Destruction Warlock that you stop as many Chaos Bolts as possible. Thugonomics looking for some crowd control to set up a Chaos Bolt. It's going to be trying to burst down Jamie. No Grounding Totem, but only one connects. Chun-Li not able to follow up. The control of ABC has been solid. Their damage and pressure equally so. Azgarath gets swapped to. Bit of a surprise attack from the boys as they're mixing things up.
Yep, Chun-Li putting some pressure on Azgarath, managing to get out that Bark Skin. If they can swap to him again, it could be the Gladiator's Medallion from Azgarath where he can ultimately fall. So look out for that next leg sweep, that next bash coming in from the boys. Double leg sweep coming in from Chun-Li. Decent pressure onto Alec. He trinkets out to avoid some damage, putting Chun-Li into a polymorph, limiting some of that pressure. And like I said, for ABC, it's about stalling it out to the late game, just bullying Thugonomics as much as you can on the Elemental Shaman, on the Frost Mage. Just make sure he's snared up, he's interrupted, and he can't get too much done. And for ABCs, it's been working out pretty well so far.
All right, ABC, you're looking solid, but I think mana is in favor of the boys. So the boys hold out. They might be able to stall this match and win on mana against Azgarath. Mana being the blue bar below the health bars, and the health bars being the big bars on each player's frame on your screen. Gorecki moving forward, looking like he wants to get some crowd control, bashing Azgarath. Alec the target, already in a good position to avoid damage though from Thugonomics. Azgarath actually gets swapped to by Chun-Li. Chun-Li is constantly just feeling it out, trying to see if he can get a surprise attack on Azgarath. Manages to at least pull Ironbark. Now he can switch targets. Nice play by Chun-Li. Banking a cooldown, now potentially getting an ice block as a result if they can get more damage out. But Alec is avoiding Thugonomics effectively. Jamie supporting with Lightning Lasso, denying the reconnect. Azeroth repositions, but he's expended a lot of mana to heal through the swaps of Chun-Li, and it is really Chun-Li's target switching that is putting his team ahead.
Yep, switching targets, keeping up that mortal wounds effect from the Rising Sun kick. Makes it very difficult for the Restoration Druid to deal with that damage. Azeroth with a nice Bash Cyclone on Chun-Li, getting some control of the matchup. But like you kind of mentioned, Sid, right now, in terms of mana, the boys have a massive lead. It's going to be up to them to make sure they prevent Azeroth from getting out of combat, sitting down for those drinks. You can see Azeroth positioned so far away. Gorecki realizing this, he's going to try to chase him down. It really is a game of cat and mouse, or cat and cat, for these two druids to try to limit their opportunities. Ooh. To recover mana.
Mistimed by Azeroth. Gorecki rotates the crowd control back in his own favor. Mistakes are starting to be made here by ABC. Alec is already down an ice block at a point in this match, now with only one remaining. Significant mana lead for the boys, and it's looking better and better for them. Substituting in Thugonomics was a great idea and tactic for them in this series, and winning the blind pick the first round means that you will have the advantage should this swing to a game five. This match is of the utmost importance for both sides, and the boys continue to build their lead.
Yeah, life sweep on Azeroth. No trinket, no barkskin now. This is a great opportunity for the boys. They could potentially make an all-in out of this if Gorecki gets his bash up. If Thugonomics Chun-Li can land some sort of damage on the Azeroth, they might be able to take him down. Very vulnerable. It's going to be up to Alec and Jamie to make sure they can keep him alive. Good pressure on Chun-Li. Lightning Lasso coming in. Thugonomics needs to shut that down. Chun-Li could just fall. Gets a touch of karma off. A good fortifying brew before that Lightning Lasso. That may be the only thing that kept Chun-Li alive.
Another swap. Switching over to Jamie. Trying to spend more mana from Azeroth, but Jamie is able to escape. Although not away from the Chaos Bolts of Thugonomics. Crowd control on Azeroth. Chun-Li switching targets again over to Alec. Thugonomics sets up with a double Mortal Coil into a Fear. Good crowd control. Great play by Thugonomics in this position, getting a ton of pressure out. Can they get more follow-up is the question. Doesn't look like they have it. Azeroth's out, but he doesn't have cooldowns. This could be the second ice block. Alec interrupted on Polymorph. Lightning Lasso to buy time. That gets interrupted. Alec's in trouble. He's starting to flail here. Azeroth in position with Tranquility going. Needs to be enough. Looks like it is for now, but double leg sweep. Mistakes made by ABC. That triangle positioning is starting to be blundered away. Alec in that vortex, not able to escape. He's going to get pulled back to Chun-Li. Chun-Li just staying on target and slowly and surely tapping that mana bar, dampening, ramping up to critical mass.
Yeah, the boys building momentum in this matchup. Thugonomics gets interrupted. Do they have the damage to really punish him? They've been going after Chun-Li, but I feel like ABC, they need to start putting their attention onto Thugonomics once again. There's a Lightning Lasso. Thugonomics trinkets out, lands a full Fear onto Azeroth. Alec could be in a little bit of trouble right now. He's not running the Temporal Shield. There's the Mortal Coil. Chaos Bolt lands. Alec getting out of line of sight with the Iron Bark does manage to hold on to that second ice block, and that's going to be very important. They're at around 18% damping right now. Gorecki's mana, just a massive lead over Azeroth. ABC, this is looking dangerous for them.
It's looking solid for the boys, though, and North America in the lower bracket. There's only two North American teams left in the tournament and four Europeans. So if you're a CDU fan or a Method Orange fan, you need to be rooting for the North American teams, because that could open up potentially more slots for North American teams later on in the year. It is very important to these teams' regions that their region finds victory on the lands if they are unable to, so they have a better shot of qualifying to the World Finals. There is a lot on the line, not only for the teams in this match, but every team competing for each region.
Yep. Thugonomics with a little bit of a misplay there. Actually missed his Infernal Stun, so didn't get too much value there. Infernals are out. Big Chaos Bolts by Thugonomics. Manages to find one on Azeroth. If he found that second, that would have been dangerous. Very nice interrupt there by Alec. Chun-Li getting rooting up behind the pillar. What is he going to do? All three members of ABC trying to reposition on the other side of the map. They realize Azeroth, at some point, he has to be able to recover his mana, but the boys have just been shutting that down so consistently. You can see the Fel Hunter from Thugonomics just chasing him down. Alec and Jamie, they need to start trying to find some damage on Thugonomics. They need counter pressure in this matchup.
All right, dampening's getting high, but Alec gets bursted. He's got 1 minute to that cold snap. Can he make it? He's holding out with Kona cold snares, but they connect. He's interrupted on Froth for one more second. Gorecki's dishing out some extra damage. Azeroth caught in the Fear. Where's the Tremor Totem? No Tremor Totem from Jamie. That Fear is sitting full duration into a paralysis. Will this cost him an ice block? Azeroth pinned against the wall with that Ring of Peace is trying to make it back to his team. Alec has slowly but surely recovered. Now Azeroth initiating crowd control on Gorecki, actually for a swap. Big swap from ABC, trying to pull victory out of nowhere here. They're so far behind, if they don't find a kill, Gorecki Shadow Melds the Glider's Maledict, avoids the healing absorption. They go all in on Gorecki, but he's escaped already. They're not going to find the kill unless Jamie solos him. He's given up the chase. Gorecki survives the swap, and now ABC, what are you doing? You got no mana left. You've only got one ice block, and Alec's already low.
this is not the positioning Alec wants in this matchup. He has Thugonomics basically just teeing off on him. He's caught in midfield, gets caught into the bash, into a fear. Chun-Li chasing down Azeroth really wants to limit those drinks. If they can just shut down those drinks, they will win this match. Azeroth literally has no mana left. Thugonomics gets interrupted. Big burst damage from ABC. Can they find the counter kill? Thugonomics still has a lot of defensive cooldowns to work with. It would be a throwaway at this point for the boys. They have a commanding lead in this matchup. Alec caught into the fear. Thugonomics really bullying the boy, or really bullying ABC at this point in the match. Chun-Li just training down Azeroth. Lands a nice double stun onto Jamie and Azeroth. Chun-Li's been doing an excellent job in this matchup, making sure he's consistently landing those double stuns off positional errors from ABC.
All of this damage is going to just continue getting higher and higher. Thugonomics' Warlock is paying off here in game number one, and this is the games that we like to see from the Warlocks. Damage across the board, all three members in trouble, no mana left, and Azeroth is somehow keeping his team going for what will be a miracle kill if ABC can pull it off. Thugonomics gets bursted. No response from the boys just yet in terms of cooldowns. They feel confident. They're pushing forward. Ice block forced from Alec. Fortunately for him, cold snap available. We'll have another one. Jamie is still low, though. Thugonomics is boldly in midfield. Can Jamie pull off the miracle? He's bursting him. Alec blinks forward as well. It's do or die to kill Thugonomics. Frozen Orb is down. Thugonomics can use the gateway to safety if he needs to. It doesn't look like he has to. Ironbark's defense activated by Garecki. Still with a slight mana lead. Dampening getting higher. Thugonomics recovering. But the damage has been dealt with. Somehow, some way, Azeroth has topped his team off at this point. Innervate timed. He's getting full heal over time effects loaded up onto the team with that. Thugonomics is getting bursted, and ABC, they might be able to pull off the miracle.
Yeah, off the back of that Innervate from Azeroth, making all of his cast spells free. Jamie now caught into a leg sweep. Thugonomics gets interrupted, though. There's not going to be too much backup. There is an Infernal with Chun-Li trying to take him down. Full bash. Nice crowd control by Garecki. He moves in. The boys looking to close out this game. Can they find the damage on Jamie? Alec with a beautiful polymorph into a Frost Nova on Chun-Li, really trying to slow down some of that damage. But Jamie needs to get out of midfield at this point, where ABC, they have to try to find a kill on Thugonomics. Thugonomics knows this could be dangerous for him, activating his Unending Resolve, using that to get offensive onto Jamie. Lightning Lasso gets interrupted. The boys trying to close out this game.
Ooh, Hibernate on Garecki. That could be the miracle Hibernate. Azeroth putting the team on his back
now.
Big crowd control chain
off
the back.
No way!
Despite having no mana, despite his team being so far behind, Azeroth finds the miracle Hibernate and puts a point on the board, taking that blind pick advantage.
That in mind, but still 67% of you think that the boys are going to be able to take it, even after a crushing blow last night that gets them into this elimination matchup. Even after that first loss, we're going to have to see if ABC can turn the boys into RIP. Crediting Zico on that one. He's on break, so I'm going to steal his joke.
Typical. Anyway.
Wait, you did the joke wrong.
Yeah, I think he actually...
You should have let Zico tell
you should have said the boys turn ABC into RIP.
Whoa.
Anyways.
Good damage on Alec right away. He trinkets out, blinks behind the pillar, but another Chaos Bolt lands. Alec gets another Shimmer off, trying to get out of line of sight. And once again, ABC, it's all about avoiding damage as long as possible. Eventually, Thugonomics becomes a really great target if he gets interrupted on a Chaos Bolt, if he gets interrupted on the Fear. He's kind of a sitting duck in all of these Frostmage snares, especially later on. So that is the objective of ABC for the boys. It's all about just consistent pressure, swapping around, looking for opportunities for Thugonomics to land Chaos Bolts. They could eventually get Azeroth out of mana. They were at their win condition in game number one, where ABC kind of found a miracle kill off the back of a really beautiful play of Alec and Azeroth. Have to see how this one plays out.
Pressure on both sides as Alec and Thugonomics are the main targets for each opposing team. Greki caught in crowd control, which means his two members of his team are in a bit of trouble. Now a Cyclone from Azeroth to follow up as well. Chun-Li is chilling at the pillar. The Monk that never dies, as we credited yesterday. He's got a lot of practice with the one and only Vindruki on the desk in his 2v2 combat to make sure that he trained on 100 times gravity to survive here in the tournament today. Thugonomics moving forward, but gets clotheslined by Jamie. Azeroth positioned in the far back room, and he's baiting drinks so that the opposing team runs out into midfield to stop him. And then when they're in midfield, Alec and Jamie can blow them up. I like this positioning from ABC.
Yep, great positioning from ABC, that triangle formation. And like we kind of talked about in game number one, there were a few mistakes from ABC. If Chun-Li can land a double leg sweep like this, Azeroth, what are you doing? These double leg sweeps just allow a huge amount of pressure and momentum from the boys. Anytime that happens, it is off the back of a mistake from ABC, so they have to make sure they're not stacking on top of each other, especially when Chun-Li has that leg sweep available.
All right, correct. He comes out of a Hex, connects Ironbark. Needs to be enough. Unganomics is getting blasted by Jamie right now. You can tell that Jamie wants this, carrying it down in the lower bracket. These teams are facing elimination in the first best of five of the day between North America and Europe in the spring 2019 Arena World Championship Finals. Who's going to come out ahead? There's a spot to BlizzCon on the line. There's $50,000 first place prize on the line. ABC pull off the miracle kill in game number one. Can they pull off the miracle two more times and clean sweep the boys, or are the boys going to pull it back together? Alec's getting bursted. Asgrath is interrupted and unable to heal, so Alec is going to avoid damage. And this is what we credit Alec for. He is so immaculate with his kiting and positioning defensively. That is how he won BlizzCon back in 2017. And we can see, even though Chun-Li playing a Windwalker, one of the most mobile melee in the game, Alec is kiting him effectively and pulling him into positions where he overextends in line of sight's Gorecki. So when he's polymorphed, he can't be dispelled. And this is the top level play that we expect from a team like ABC, former BlizzCon champions.
Yeah, there's a difference between some of the European mages and some of the North American mages. It seems like some of the European mages, like Alec, like Raikou, they're not afraid to just play really defensive, just really focus on getting out well-timed Ice Novas and Frost Novas and Pet Novas and just kiting, playing to their advantage in the late game, whereas some of the North American mages, they play a little bit more aggressive in more situations. So maybe that is throwing the boys for a little bit of a loop. We saw yesterday with the Windwalker Fury Warrior, they weren't able to really take down Raikou. And I know the boys, they said they had a lot more pressure against some of the North American mages. So the playstyle difference between the two regions kind of makes these matchups interesting.
All right, let's see what they can get done. Alec in a good position far away, and that is the main focus of the team. But Asgrath and Jamie stack up again. Double leg sweep could cost them game two.
Whoa.
Perfect stun lock by the boys, but Asgrath has Barkskin. It actually needs to be enough. Chun-Li is just owning him right now. Asgrath gets cycloned at low health. Do they have the stun diminishing return? Does Gorecki have a bash? I'm curious to see. It doesn't look like he does. Asgrath will recover. A bit of a close call. Deeper in Dampening definitely can't afford to make mistakes like that. Now Alec the target. Infernals have landed. Thugonomics is setting up for some big bolts.
Yeah, looking for those Chaos Bolts, but ABC knows exactly what is going on. You can see they're just turtling up behind the pillar, just avoiding as much damage as possible. Alec gets interrupted on the Polymorph, looking for a Ring of Frost. Unfortunately, denied there. Gorecki's positioned quite far away. Thugonomics right now with Gorecki is going to be protecting him from some crowd control, but right now, ABC is relatively split up, and Chun-Li is developing quite a bit of pressure onto Alec.
Yeah, two targets, a two-pronged assault by the boys, with Thugonomics going after Jamie and Chun-Li going after Alec. They had to expend the Astral Shift for Jamie to recover, and Asgrath was able to stabilize Alec, so ABC not cracking under the pressure and the strategy adaptation from the boys mid-game. Chun-Li now overextended. This is the position I was talking from ABC. Gorecki then walks into crowd control. Asgrath capitalizing on that. Good play here from ABC. That is going to bank them the fortifying Elixir and Ironbark from the boys. If they can keep kiting cross midfield, they can definitely find a kill through this strategy. See if they can keep it up.
Yeah, Chun-Li activates the Touch of Death. Can they get the second ice block from Alec? Fist of Fury coming flying in, but Alec is taking no damage. Ironbark negating all of that pressure. Ooh. Now it's Chun-Li that's in trouble. He might have to trade out that Touch of Karma. Doesn't want to wait to get too low. Interrupt on Alec. Chun-Li rolls away to the safety of Gorecki behind the pillar. Here's a nice little regrowth. And Chun-Li does get topped off. But we look at mana, this is a different story. Asgaroth has been playing much more efficiently in this matchup. I think ABC, they realize the game plan of the boys. They've been adapting to this composition. Now they're actually swinging the mana edge in their favor. Oh. But as I say that, Gorecki positioned across the entire map, recovering basically full mana. Now the boys get a slight lead.
And Gorecki gets full mana at a critical moment where Dampening has just entered the battle. So this was a nice reaction from Gorecki. Certainly keeping it calm, cool, and collected despite some tilting matches so far in the tournament. Playing it at a professional level, most certainly. Gorecki repositioning to avoid crowd control here with Thugonomics. Chun-Li sees Jamie overextended, so he's going to switch to Jamie. Big damage combined here with the Lightning Lasso. Alec is free casting. Curious to see who makes the move. Both Restoration Druids positioned far away from each other. And when they move forward to initiate crowd control, that is going to be a dangerous moment for either team. And I want to see who moves in first. Gorecki stuns Jamie. Alec is baiting Chun-Li, but I'm not sure how much of a bait it is. Thugonomics is there to back him up, tossing out a Chaos Bolt. Alec blinks away with Asgrath, repositioning, kiting across midfield once again. The only thing that I really feel like ABC are making big mistakes about is Asgrath's positioning occasionally too close to his teammates. And if they stack up for a double leg sweep, that could cost them the match. So he definitely needs to make sure he's keeping an eye on his teammates, not getting too close.
Yeah, good pressure here from Chun-Li. Lance a full leg sweep on Alec. Azeroth immediately responding with the Iron Bark. Nicely done. Now Jamie taking a few Chaos Bolts. Thugonomics really just looking for pressure and momentum where he can. That is how the boys play this setup. Chun-Li, he bounces around, finds consistent damage, tries to shut down Alex. Polymorphs is Frostbolt spam, limiting some of that Frostmage damage. Whereas Thugonomics, he's constantly just moving in, trying to find damage on Alec, but Alec makes that very difficult. So Thugonomics, if he can find pressure on Jamie and Azeroth, that's his job, to just tax the mana of Azeroth in this matchup. Touch Death landing onto Alec. What are they going to be able to do? There's no Iron Bark available. Thugonomics can find some burst. So difficult. Alec is kiting around the pillar. Thugonomics caught into the snare as he's trying to chase him, but it is a very slow walk to attack a Frostmage.
Yeah, Chun-Li is doing his best. He desperately wanted to get an ice block with that attempt, but not finding it. Big heal from Gorecki. Very low health on Chun-Li, but no overreaction, no overcommitment in their defensive lineup. Both teams continue to play clean in game number two. Ring of Frost connects. Chun-Li is polymorphed, and Thugonomics, he's in midfield with really nowhere to go too quickly. He's going to Mortal Coil, fear Alec, and deny any burst. Chun-Li is pressuring Jamie, so they couldn't capitalize on that crowd control whatsoever. Jamie now getting soloed by Chun-Li. Thugonomics fears Azeroth out of range of the Tremor Totem. That banks them an Astral Shift, so nice pressure from Chun-Li. Good crowd control for Thugonomics, and they continue pushing the lead.
Yep, Jamie taking a little bit of pressure right now, but once again, it's just so difficult for Thugonomics to get off the damage that he really needs, and ABC is doing exactly what I thought they would do. They just snare up Thugonomics, they just really limit the Destruction Warlock damage. But Destruction Warlock can cast Fears, he can cast Chaos Bolts. It's a very dangerous class, but he's just snared up. Everyone's out of line of sight. That is when it becomes Omega frustrating for Thugonomics to really play that Destruction Warlock.
Omega!
Curious to see if Thugonomics, the Alpha Warlock, can get a kill here in game number two for his team, or if they're going to falter towards the final seconds of the match. Because in deep dampening, really, anything can happen. Even if it looks like you've been winning the entire match, at 40% dampening, one big swing can knock you clean out. So ABC still stand a chance here, despite being so far behind, with dampening getting to critical levels. 27% healing reduction. Thugonomics has good presence of mind with that Fell Hunter demon chasing Azeroth. He needs to make sure that that is constantly hunting Azeroth and punching him in the face to keep him in combat and denying him from drinking to regenerate mana for late game potential kills. Crowd control across the board here on ABC. The boys push for big cooldowns. How much damage do they have? They swap to Jamie. No Astral Shift for two more seconds. Azeroth bides the time with Iron Bark, and it looks like it's going to be enough. But now Alec left open without that defense, and Chun-Li sees that opening. Touch of Death immediately activated by him. This is going to be an ice block, most certainly. Alex is going to respect the Touch of Death, but that's exactly the cooldown Chun-Li wants to get with it at exactly the right time. So the boys are still looking solid with their game plan.
Infernals are going to be available for Thugonomics in around 20 seconds. That could potentially be the second ice block of Alec if the boys can line it up correctly. 32% dampening. If we look at mana, Azeroth around 20%. We'll have to see where Gorecki stands at around 80% or even higher. So right now, the boys, in terms of mana, once again, they're doing great. But that's what we saw in the Grand Arena as well. And eventually, the ABC was just able to overwhelm Gorecki with one crowd control chain to take Thugonomics down. So the boys have to be prepared for that all-in one-shot setup. You can see ABC, Alec, he has his Icy Veins available, so there's going to be major offense available for ABC at basically the perfect moment in this match.
Good Shadow Meld by Alec, avoiding that Gladiator's Maledict during a push of the boys. That is buying Azeroth some breathing room, and he really needs a lot of room. That's not a lot of mana left to work with now at 36% dampening. Gorecki is a lot more comfortable, and it's interesting that Tolvron is actually advantaged to the boys. I was a bit surprised by this map selection on their part. I thought that the Frostmage Elemental Shaman would have been a lot better, but Azeroth is finding it difficult to drink even on one of the biggest maps in pool. Jamie at half health and no mana. What are you going to do, Azeroth? You're put in the same situation where you have to pull off a miracle, but fully capable of it. That Polymorph Hibernate combo is so deadly. The boys need to be ready for that. They need to protect Gorecki from crowd control during that final push, and if they can do so, their lead is so significant that they should overwhelm ABC momentarily.
Yeah, definitely. You can see Chun-Li pushing in. Jamie getting really low. Rekki caught into a full bash cyclone. Counter pressure here for ABC, but they just can't find the damage they need. Chun-Li already hiding behind the pillar. Thugonomics in a good position as well, just spamming out fear onto Alec. And although ABC got nice crowd control on Gorecki, there was just no damage to follow it up whatsoever. Good preemptive plays by the boys. Now the boys need to continue their momentum, continue their push. Touch of death once again available for Chun-Li. Alec, this could be his second ice block, potentially the last ice block of the game.
Right before touch of death.
Yeah, things are looking really good for the boys.
Chun-Li has this game in his back pocket. There's Infernal, there's touch of death, there's no mana. If they lose at this point, it's a complete throwaway. Maybe they do, though. There's a Hex. No stop on the Hex. Chun-Li in trouble. Low on health. Grecky's got mana to recover, though, and Azgrath doesn't have that luxury. They're trying to keep their pressure on Chun-Li. They're trying to force him to run away. They know he's a big threat with that touch of death, but equally so is Thugonomics with Infernals. They
nice.
Swap to Azgrath. Infernals are in. One Chaos Bolt is going to close this if Thugonomics... They don't even need it. Touch of death about to explode. Azgrath has no mana to heal, and he's too low on health. Touch of death. KO! Azgrath goes down, and the boys' game plan pays off in game two.
TC, they're going to know exactly what's going on with diminishing returns. And also, Venricki, on top of that, look at Alec. There's no way that he's going to miss an ice block with all of these add-ons that are currently available.
Dude, this joke. I mean, I appreciate that. Okay, yeah, what joke? All right,
ABC. You a little sensitive about something?
No, come on, man. All right, Super T's, go ahead.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, we're tied up 1-1 between ABC and the boys. North America versus Europe in the lower bracket. Both of these teams face elimination. Nixie substituted in for Jamie. ABC, they're desperate to find an answer. Can their rogue mage druid be enough to overcome the boys? Thugonomics, Chun-Li, and Gorecki with this Windwalker Destruction Warlock as both teams are trading blows early on. No significant punches thrown just yet. Finally, Chun-Li's Fist of Fury flying. No Chaos Bolts, though, paired up with it. Thugonomics trying to fake cast some interrupts before going for it or safely cast a Fear into a Chaos Bolt. Looking for that one now here. Gets counterspelled by Alec and denied. Azgrath in the back line getting big, expensive heals for free on that Innervate. Well-timed. Alec, he's moving forward. Nixie's moving up. Azgrath looks like he wants to get in there, but he's a little bit hesitant.
Yeah, and this matchup plays out quite similarly for ABC. Instead of the Elemental Shaman, you have the Assassination Rogue. And Assassination Rogues are quite good at shutting down a Destruction Warlock. You have the low cooldown kick as an interrupt, as well as that low cooldown kidney shot, the single target stun. If you can land a kick, you can land a kidney shot consistently onto Thugonomics, you can really limit his ability to get out burst damage. It's the same kind of thing. ABC, they want to drag out the game as long as possible. When they can get crowd control on Gorecki, that's when Alec is going to use the Empowered Spell Steal with Kleptomania, remove all the heal over time effects from Thugonomics, and that's when they can really start getting pressure rolling with the Frozen Orb, Comet Storm, and Ice Nova.
All right, big Chaos Bolt's flying over towards Alec. Thugonomics is dishing out some juicy ones here in game number three. Alec's going to duck for cover downstairs. The Chun-Li is in hot pursuit. Good positioning on Azgrath to entangling root Chun-Li, but likely has Tiger's Lust. No Tiger's Lust. Ring of Peace bounces Alec back, but then he blinks away from the Fist of Fury and polymorphs it during Touch of Death. Good reaction from Alec, not panicking during that moment. Touch of Death is totally negated for no real cost. Well done from ABC. Good positioning.
Yeah, definitely good positioning. Chun-Li, once again, they want to secure that mana lead, so Chun-Li making sure he's chasing down Azgrath, denying any time he gets out of combat, and looking to sip on some of that precious water. If he can drink on that water for long enough, he will be able to recover his mana, so that's why the boys are just making sure they're playing on top of him, not letting him escape, not letting him get out of combat. They can secure that mana lead in the late game. Nixie with another kitty shot on Thugonomics. Decent backup from Alec, but doesn't seem like he really has too much damage right now. Chun-Li's been pressuring him down quite a bit. This could potentially be the first ice block. Paralysis on Azgrath. Chun-Li in hot pursuit, but Alec with his kiting out of line of sight of Thugonomics, I think he should be able to survive.
Well done with these Frost Novas of Alec, spacing them out to try and get around that Tiger's Lust of Chun-Li, which breaks Frost Nova effects. So good positioning and avoidance from ABC. Again, that's what we credit them for. That's what got them their BlizzCon victory. So being able to stall a game, most certainly a strength of ABC. Let's see if they can execute on crowd control and burst, though, to find victory. We see crowd control engaged by Azgrath, though, denied by Chun-Li with a double leg sweep. Gorecki going to be thankful for the support there of his player Chun-Li. Nixie still pressuring Thugonomics, but with no crowd control, he is easily recovering. Gorecki looks like he may be trying to sneak away and drink. Curious to find out how much mana he actually gets. Mana still too close to call any significant advantage at this point, and still anyone's match in game three.
Yeah, definitely anyone's match, but as the game goes longer and longer, Thuganomics becomes more of a vulnerability in this matchup. So the boys, they have to secure their mana lead. They have to make sure they keep up the consistent pressure, because eventually Thuganomics, he's going to fall to this assassination rogue. There's no question about it. It's only a matter of time. They have to try to close out the game before then. They have to really limit what Alex is able to do. And I got to give credit to Chun-Li and Thuganomics. They've been putting a lot of pressure on Alec in this matchup. Paralysis now on Azeroth. Gorecki moving in into a full Rake stun. Potential Cyclone, but no, Nyxie shuts it down. It looks like ABC, they actually want to make a swap on a Gorecki, but he gets in bear form, and I think he should be okay.
Gorecki is actually running the Spring Blossoms talent, so his Efflorescence adds some extra healing, and this can be very effective against a Rogue Mage setup, because you can put your Efflorescence down on your team member before you get crowd-controlled, and with the added extra healing, it can be just enough to survive a crowd-control chain. That is one significant difference between Gorecki and Azgarath's build, but although switching to Gorecki is a great plan when a Druid is running this build,
nice.
Not using the Efflorescence at this point, which is a bit surprising. He's falling behind as a result of lack of healing with that talent. Selection. His Iron Bark is a significantly longer cooldown without the Stone Bark to reduce it. I'm curious if ABC can find that swap opportunity for a kill that is likely to be their main win condition.
Yeah, Azeroth was playing very aggressive there. The boys basically had no choice but to try to get some pressure. There's a nice double life sweep from Chun-Li, but Azeroth did manage to escape unscathed. With no Trinket, Barskin and Iron Bark could be a little bit of trouble, but the Infernal Threat is gone from Thuganomics, so ABC's got to be feeling relatively healthy, although they haven't been able to develop too much pressure at this point. That was a nice swap on Gorecki, but he managed to live. Now Nyxie chasing him down, gets caught into a Rake stun. Thuganomics moving in. Alec and Azeroth just kiting away. Good positioning here. Just very far away, but Nyxie could be a little bit vulnerable. He's trying to just solo down Gorecki. Alec finally gets there for some assisted damage. Frozen Orb gets dropped out, but Thuganomics with the Fear Spam, with the Shadow Fury, was able to shut down that attempt. And I really feel like when they make these swaps on a Gorecki, there has to be a counterspell available from Alec to shut down the fears of Thuganomics. Otherwise, I feel like it's just wasted time.
All right, Alec avoiding a near-death experience there, tag teaming with Azeroth to recover. Gorecki is the target of choice here from ABC. It appears that they've given up all hope on killing any other target. They've got crowd control on three members. This is a good move by ABC. Can they pull off a kill? They're getting pretty close. Gorecki disrespecting the burst. He's also running Feral Affinity, which means he can't rely on Frenzied Regeneration to recover. So the lower that he goes, the riskier that it gets. Nyxie feared away, support by Thuganomics, but Azeroth is jumping into the fight, adding some extra stuns. Gorecki manages to just walk it off and make it back to the pillar, trying to sneak in a Hibernate. Gets denied by Azeroth. Good dodge.
Yep, good dodge by Azeroth. Now Chun-Li turning his attention on Alec, but these consistent setups from ABC on a Gorecki are actually really scary. Gorecki at this point, no Trinket, no Barfskin. If they can get another Kidney Shot out of form, Gorecki could easily fall. It's going to be up to Thuganomics to make sure he has his Mortal Coil available, he has some stuns available to keep him alive. That's really the only vulnerable target I see for the boys right now. ABC definitely wants to capitalize on that.
All right, let's see if they can capitalize on it. Mana is now much more in favor of the boys, and potentially this Rogue Mage is not going to work out for them. And if it doesn't, what do you do? I mean, the Frostmage Elemental is surely their strongest or most practiced composition. I would say that the Rogue Mage is a close second. Maybe we see some Arcane, but Arcane into a Warlock? That doesn't sound too good. Chun-Li's got Touch of Death rolling. He's trying to get some pressure as they switch targets to Nyxie. No Cloak of Shadows, no Glaire's Medallion. Big hits. Azeroth, though, innervate perfectly timed. Is it going to be enough? Feral Affinity damage adding to the mix. Doesn't look like it's going to be enough. Nyxie survives the swap, engaging crowd control, getting the Gladiator's Medallion of Gorecki, opening them up for a switch with that for Icy Veins and the Vendetta. So ABC have two of their most powerful cooldowns, and they got Gorecki's Gladiator's Medallion, so he cannot escape a Kidney Shot. If ABC execute perfectly here, they can find a kill, and Gorecki knows he's the target. He uses Demonic Gateway to cross the map. Azeroth intercepts him, actually decides to Cyclone him. They're switching targets. They're going to go after Thuganomics instead, but I mean, really? They're not even scratching him despite the full Cyclone. I do not think they're going to be able to kill Ty. Oh, but they get the Polymorph. Polymorph might be enough. The Thuganomics interrupted. Can they pull it off then?
Great crowd control from Alec and Azeroth. That Hibernate Polymorph combo could bank them a win. Gorecki with no Trinket. Thuganomics in a lot of trouble. He's already used the Unending Resolve, hovering around 20% health right now. They're trying to get counter pressure on Alec, but the Smoke Bomb gets dropped out. ABC could take him down right here, right now. Azeroth moving in. Thuganomics gates away, but it is not enough. ABC secure their lead in the series.
And then you also look on the side of the boys, and as much as we're talking about ABC right now and everything they've accomplished in years past, when you look at this year in particular, the boys in their region have had a stronger year than ABC has had. The boys have looked very good in North America, and they want to try to even this one up here on Hook Point.
You can tell that Gorecki is focused there in the bottom left of your screen. Going to need to be a shot caller. Hook Point's a dangerous map, smallest in the pool, close quarter combat, one mistake, one misstep in terms of positioning, as we already see Alec and Nixie making mistakes stacked up together, getting double stunned, but Alex Shadow Meld equally skilled in dodging a Gladiator's Maledict healing absorption. They survived the first attack, but it's the first of many.
Yeah, definitely. Spexen now caught into a polymorph. Chun-Li trying to deny some damage from Nixie. Nixie moving across the map, doesn't want to get caught behind the pillar in a stun when Azeroth is in crowd control. Azeroth now activating the innervate, but here's an attempt onto Chun-Li. He's into a kidney shot. Do they have the damage to follow it up? DR bash on Chun-Li. Could just fall. Gladiator safeguard as well, as the touch of karma was traded out there by Chun-Li from the boys. He's going to be vulnerable. Gorecki knows that he is also a target in this matchup. Now Chun-Li looking to get aggressive and reverse the pressure. Touch of death was used onto Alec, but he blinks away. Chun-Li caught into a kidney shot, and unfortunately, the boys weren't able to find the damage they needed.
Nixie sets up crowd control with cheap shots. Azeroth jumps over for the Cyclone. Nixie gets in position to support Alec. Good attempt here by ABC, banking them in the anti-magic zone. However, fairly exchanged for Alec's Icy Vein, so no significant cooldown lead. Smexen keeps it cool, protecting his teammate. But now moving forward, there's still no touch of karma for 47 seconds. That's important for Chun-Li to be able to survive. We see Nixie dodging a leg sweep by just playing on the outskirts of both Smexen and Chun-Li, avoiding that stun and making sure that he's not opening himself up for a swap, allowing Azeroth to spend a lot less mana and a lot less cooldowns. Good awareness from ABC, and if they can keep this play up, potentially they just take the series.
Yeah, Alec is just so patient with his blinks, his temporal shield. Anytime Chun-Li is going to use his images, use his Fist of Fury, Alec just immediately blinks away. And I was taking a look at some of his talents. He is stacking that cauterizing blink. So when Alec does decide to use those shimmer charges, that blink to get away from combat, he also gets a little bit of a heal. So very patient with his mobility, not wasting it, making sure that the boys, they have to commit some of those damage cooldowns in order for him to trade out that mobility. And I think that's just really intelligent from Alec, and it makes him a really difficult target to take down.
We saw a swap to Gorecki by Nixie, pulling a Barkskin, right, as Vendetta is available. Nixie, he's got his sights on Gorecki, I would think. At least that's what likely Gorecki is thinking through his mind. But if ABC are predicting that, then maybe they go after a different target to try and catch him off guard. Kidney shot on Chun-Li. This is to try and pull Iron Bark from Gorecki. He's not falling for that. Azeroth in a polymorph that was stolen by Smexen's Dark Simulacrum. Nice play by Smexen. Definitely trying to carry the team. He was substituted in for Thugonomics, playing well. Any stolen polymorph with that honor talent could net them a kill. Again, ooh, gripped into a double stun. Nice play here. This might be an ice block. Then they could switch to Azeroth as well if they need to. They're trying to buy time with Iron Bark. Azeroth fake cast the mind freeze. Goes for a cyclone. Nice play. ABC set up a swap. Everybody's in a stun.
Uh-oh.
Gorecki's in trouble. The boys are on match point. Ray of Frost almost fully channeled. Gorecki on the run, on the ropes. Nixie all over him. Double skin has to be enough. Big swift mend. The Glare's Maledict is still absorbing some heals. Gorecki tries to jump to safety. Chun-Li trying to support, but Nixie and Azeroth in hot pursuit. Tag teaming to take down Gorecki, but Alec can't get there to support. Gorecki survives, but with no cooldowns, he shapeshifts out of form. If Alec can get over there and deal any damage, Gorecki's going to be in a lot of trouble.
Yep, Gorecki in a lot of trouble right now, although now behind the pillar, Alec still trying to throw in some damage. Gorecki trying to cross the map. If Nixie can get there with a Shadow Step, this is going to be devastation for Gorecki. Nixie just a slow walk over a Smexen, trying to defend Gorecki with the Chains of Ice. Now Chun-Li reconnecting. Gorecki should be fine. He's almost bought enough time for that barf skin, for that trinket. And once those cooldowns rotate back up, the boys got to be feeling very safe. But they've been on top of Alec in this matchup, still not able to get out a single ice block. But if we look at mana, there is a slight lead for the boys.
Yeah, they've got a slight lead. I mean, throughout this entire series in terms of mana, but they have to stay alive and make no mistakes whatsoever. It's match point. They're going to be sent home. $50,000 first place prize. BlizzCon spot on the line here in this elimination series between the boys and ABC. Azeroth doing everything to try and regenerate mana and find drinks, but denied constantly by Chun-Li. Nixie setting up for a kill, placing down the smoke bomb, looking to see if the boys overextend their defensive lineup. Gorecki disrespecting that smoke bomb, actually just sits down for a drink. The smoke bomb doesn't bank them any cooldowns. Gorecki gets full mana. The boys have a significant lead. Can they make it, Ben? Can they go to a game five?
No, we'll definitely have to see. They need to win this game if they want to stay in this tournament. Everything on the line for the boys. ABC looking to send them packing home. Alec right now taking a little bit of pressure. Dampening has just kicked in on this matchup, but I just don't see it going that late into Dampening on hook point on this smaller map. Chun-Li now caught into a kidney shot. Once again, Spell Seal going to be traded out by Alec. I believe he is playing that Kleptomania talent. Yes, he's playing both Temporal Shield and Kleptomania in this particular matchup, so they can get really aggressive. There's swaps on a Gorecki. Anytime there's a kidney shot committed by Nixie, Alex is going to be able to back him up by removing all of those precious Restoration Druid heal over time effects. That's what makes this setup so devastating. Chun-Li now on Alec. Alex actually pulling the trigger on Icy Veins. ABC, they want to get aggressive. They get a full kidney shot on Chun-Li with a blind on Gorecki. Gorecki immediately trinkets out, trying to reposition as Azeroth moves in, manages to find the full bash. If they get the Ring of Frost, it's going to be so scary. Polymorph Hibernate. Once again, Gorecki caught in the situation. There's really not too much he could do. Chun-Li all by himself.
All right, Chun-Li, what are you going to do? The monk that never dies, will he make it out alive? He has to at this point. If he dies here, he's got no more second chances. He's very low on health, has cooldowns to trade, but is holding out. Nixie connects. Dangerous time here for the boys. If they can kill him at the end of this stun, Smexen, he got the anti-magic zone just in time. This purple shield, really the only thing keeping Chun-Li alive right now, as he's trying to be greedy with the rest of his cooldowns, but he's getting punished for the greed. Touch of Karma, 10% health. Close call. Chun-Li makes it out alive, and look at the mana. Azeroth basically has nothing.
Yeah, just a little bit of mana left to work with, but you can't count ABC out just yet. In game number one, Azeroth was for quite a while, and they still managed to find a win. We'll have to see what exactly happens. Double grip, leg sweep on Azeroth and Nixie. Decent pressure here for the boys. They need to find a little bit more damage. Everyone's kind of rotting down, and Azeroth still doesn't have that precious innervate for another 15 seconds. It might be wise for him to just wait to put his heal over time effects on everyone so he can catch up with that innervate, making all of his spells free of charge. It's a very powerful ability. In the meantime, though, Alec getting really low. Azeroth holding onto that Iron Bark, playing it patient, but a full stun. This could cost the first Ice Walk of Alec in this matchup. Not the best situation to be in. Gladiator Safeguard procs. Alec is just so greedy with that Ice Block, just plays it out so clinically. Never uses the Ice Block unless he absolutely has to.
Azeroth activating that discount code, Innervate, to get some free heals. Stabilize the team with almost nothing left, and that's equalized the mana. That's equalized the playing field. It's still anyone's match. ABC could take it and advance in the lower bracket, eliminating the boys, but equally so, the boys could as well. Touch of Death respected by Alec. He's going to trade Ice Block immediately so that he can just turn tail and push forward. Nixie, he's trying to get reconnect to Chun-Li. Smexen is snaring up Alec, preventing him from crossing field, but now polymorphed. Gorecki not able to dispel that. Smexen's locked out of the match. Chun-Li's locked down in a stun. Transcendence across the field to try and stay alive. Gorecki was left behind. He repositions. Smexen and Chun-Li will now both connect. Ring of Peace knocks him into a double stun. Nice play by Chun-Li.
Yeah, nicely done. Fist of Fury now on Alec. He blinks away once again. There's only one Ice Block left. It is very unlikely Alec does hold on long enough to get three in this matchup. So the boys, they have one task left. If they can get through that second Ice Block, they got one check mark out of the way. If they can get through the Temporal Shield, which they have, as well as the Iron Bark, that is a recipe for a second Ice Block in this matchup. Azeroth moving in. Alec looking for a full Ring of Frost, manages to find it once again. Chun-Li all alone. He portals away. Pre-fortifying Brew, he realizes he is the main target. He just needs to survive as long as he can. He's been doing a good job kiting in this matchup. If he can avoid damage, if he can survive, the boys could easily claim this game.
Everything riding on Chun-Li to stay alive, but as Dampening get higher, Death Knights become a liability, so maybe ABC mix it up. They keep Chun-Li on the defensive, and then at a moment's notice, turn tail, they start attacking Smexen and try and take him down. Let's see if ABC connects you. They're still going after Chun-Li. Gorecki's in a triple cyclone. Nice timing here by Azeroth, but that was stolen by Smexen, who now lands a cyclone of his own, but Gorecki gets polymorph. He has to use the Glider's Medallion on a polymorph. He's going to be open to blind, and even still before blind, Chun-Li is in trouble. Anti-magic zone has to be committed. It's a race down to the finish, down to the wire between these teams on match point. How much longer can Chun-Li stay alive? Ring of Peace protects him from Nixie, but Alec is just teeing off with Frostbolt, Flurry combo, and Alec snipes the kill for the team. 3-1 advancing in the lower bracket.
That feed versus the fake Zebras, we're all tied up 1-1. Who is going to find themselves on match point? Who is going to get a little bit further into this tournament? Keep in mind, folks, we're doing a brand new thing. You have just entered, in the middle of history, the longest series that has ever been played in Battle for Azeroth.